like my leverage. That would definitely be the easiest way to get me to fumble. Stick them right in the gut.
Yeah, well, number one, we have a lot of guys that on our staff that played at Boise State, so that's obviously pretty neat. But it's just a bunch of guys that are all working towards the same thing. And the guys on our staff are great. You know, we got great coaches, but they're great people, you know, and they all care about being with the players and watching them develop, and it makes it very exciting.
Count throws it left side, end zone, touchdown. And it is Dan Paul. Dan Paul subbing for Richie Brockle with his third touchdown catch.
At the tight end fullback position, there's a lot of different skills that they have, but really most importantly is guys that want to compete and want to get better. Because with all those different skills, you know, they're not going to come in as a polished player most likely. And in order to become a polished player, they're going to have to want to compete and get better every day so that they can become that complete player that we're looking for.
Second step's got to be where, like always, vertical up the field. The first thing you should touch him with is the top of your shoulder pad. Okay, your top of your shoulder pad. So here I am, left handed. One, two, the top of the shoulder pad should be hitting. Get through. Shot put him through like you're throwing the shot put. Okay, and then we're just gonna work to a fit. All right, so you're going right, left, you're going left, right. You guys are good, here we go. Just going to a fit. Here we go, on hit. Hit, break, okay.
You guys that are explosive, you know, so whether they're a basketball, you know, if they're a basketball player, they can dunk. If they're, they obviously got to be able to run. We want guys that want to hit and play physical on the line of scrimmage. Sometimes you have to project bigger wide receivers at that position. So you're looking for a guy that's not scared to run down the field and hit somebody. You know, just and guys that on film play hard and compete every down.
It up. Okay, no hands set. We're returning. Hey. He's the kickoff return. We're returning right. First thing we got to establish is our leverage. Okay, we're going to work for our leverage. When he gets close enough, when our hands behind our back, we're really going to work on our big, good posture, knees inside our ankles, big chest. As the return happens, we've got our leverage. Where's the returner going to eventually work? Up the field. So that's where our hand and our hip have to go to keep working with them.
Okay, so Arizona's my recruiting area for the most part, do a little bit in Vegas. It's a real natural fit, I think, for a lot of guys because Boise's can be a big city, a lot like Phoenix or Tucson can be, but it also can be a small town, maybe like a Gilbert or a Mesa or a Glendale, you know, just has a real small, you know, tight fit to it. The outdoor activities in Phoenix and in Arizona and in Boise are a lot alike. A lot of people go to the lake, to the river, to the ski resort here, a lot of hunting and fishing and stuff like that. You know, and it's a high desert, and that's a lot like what Prescott is, you know, with the four seasons, but it's still a dry heat in the summer that cools off at night. Boise's a sports town, a lot like Phoenix is or Arizona is, but we don't have a pro team. So it's kind of the best of both worlds if people are into it. But the, you know, Boise State football or Boise State University is a lot of the community and for the sports fans. And really probably Boise's a lot like Phoenix was 35 years ago, you know, in a lot of those ways. So it's been a real good fit for a lot of Arizona kids for a lot of years. And we're gonna hopefully keep bringing those guys up, and because they have been really good players for us.